Coming up, how an area cemetery worker says he's putting the memorial into Memorial Day. And local couple prepares for the arrival of their baby in the Ukraine. Plus, a grieving mother's warning, life-saving tips on water safety. Valley News Live at 10 starts right now. Good evening, everyone. Memorial Day is a time to remember and honor those who made the ultimate sacrifice. One employee at the Oak Grove Cemetery in Fergus Falls is not only honoring one veteran in particular, but giving a history lesson to everyone visiting the cemetery. Valley News Team's Nishay Taylor has this story.
Rod Berg, a Vietnam veteran, has been working at Oak Grove Cemetery since 2007 and has grown to know it like no other.
I've learned a lot of the names. I certainly don't know all of the names because there's over 8,000 burials here.
But there is one name he has become all too familiar with.
This bronze marker here is called a veteran's marker.
And that's Charles McKay, who was a Medal of Honor recipient. Every chance Rod gets, he tries to share this little piece of history.
This is the only Medal of Honor winner that we have in Oak Grove Cemetery, and I don't know how many might be in the area, but probably very, very few, if any.
According to the Congressional Medal of Honor Society, McKay was a sergeant in the Army during the U.S. Civil War. He was awarded the prestigious honor in 1864 for voluntarily risking his life to save a wounded comrade during the battle. And going the extra mile to give this history lesson to those visiting the cemetery. Some could say Rod puts the memorial into Memorial Day.
It's really an honor to help people who come to the cemetery looking for family or friends or veterans.
Rod says he does it to help keep the memories of these fallen soldiers alive.
I'm just gratified to be one of the living veterans. Having served in Vietnam, I was one of the very lucky ones that went to Vietnam. But it's important to me to recognize all veterans.
Currently, there are 650 known military burials at the cemetery. But Rod says there are several unmarked graves that date back to 1871. And there is a possibility there are more veterans resting at Oak Grove Cemetery. In Fergus Falls, Nishay Taylor, Valley News Live.
More than 3,500 people have received a Medal of Honor. Only 67 of them are still living. Dozens gathered at Sunset Memorial Gardens Cemetery in Fargo to remember their moms, dads, brothers, and sisters today who paid the ultimate sacrifice for America's freedom, many of whom come from the Red River Valley. Retired Technical Sergeant in the U.S. Air Force Russell Stabler doesn't want Americans to forget why we celebrate today.
Remember their freedom that they enjoy today cost. It cost lives.
That ceremony was one of more than 20 that took place today all across the valley. U.S. Senator Kevin Cramer participated in a Memorial Day program in Williston today. He delivered the rededication address for the Monument to the Unknown. It's a monument at Riverview Cemetery in Williston. It's believed to be the nation's first official monument to the fallen unknown soldier. It was first erected on May 30th, 1919, 2 years before the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier at Arlington National Cemetery. The Fargo Public School Board is meeting tomorrow to discuss suspending their Smart Restart plan at 11:59 p.m. tomorrow. The plan had been to suspend it on June 7th. This comes after the city of Fargo now plans to lift all mask requirements in city buildings on June 2nd. After years of trying and multiple miscarriages, a local couple is finally getting ready to have their first child together thanks to a surrogacy agency and a woman in the Ukraine. Earlier this month, Troy and Abby Durham boarded a plane to the European country after they found out one of their twins didn't make it, and their surrogate's pregnancy is now considered high risk. She's hospitalized until their baby boy makes his way into the world.
Loss after we've lost all these others, it's like, holy moly. I mean, it's an emotional journey.
The baby could come as soon as mid-June. You can hear more of that family's emotional journey by clicking this story on our website or the VNL News app. There's been a nationwide shortage of ammunition for more than a year, but one agency has found a silver lining to that shortage. The North Dakota Game and Fish Department gets funds from taxes on ammunition sales. While they are experiencing a boom in funds, they're warning hunters to be prepared for the upcoming hunting season.
As we come into fall and people start hunting, if they can't find the ammunition they need to go hunting, it may decrease some participation at some level, but usually hunters are pretty good at they've got some ammunition somewhere.
Anderson recommends hunters stock up now to ensure they're ready for the season, even though that has been the root cause of the shortage. Three men are dead after three separate fatal accidents today. Highway Patrol officers say 58-year-old Sean O'Malley of Woodbury, Minnesota, died just before 11 a.m. after rolling his vehicle in Beltrami County. The only vehicle involved, O'Malley's Jeep Wrangler, was heading south on Highway 72 when it left the road near Sunny Beach Road Northeast and rolled into a ditch. Officers didn't provide any additional information on what may have caused that accident. A 75-year-old man is dead and a woman seriously hurt following an ATV crash near Foston. That happened around 7 this morning along 345th Avenue Southeast. The ATV went into a ditch and flipped. The driver, 75-year-old Edward Halverson, died at the scene. The passenger was 71-year-old Judith Halverson. And just a half an hour later, another fatal accident. This one just south of Huff, North Dakota. A 71-year-old man died and another man is facing charges after a crash between a minivan and a sprayer. The sprayer was driving north on Highway 1806 when it was rear-ended by a Dodge Caravan. Charges are pending against that driver, 89-year-old Robert Stanley of Mandan. The driver of the sprayer was thrown and died at the scene. Last year alone, there were 65 boating and drowning deaths in Minnesota. And so far this year, that trend is seeming to continue. Susan Elizabeth Littlefield shows us how and why a family with a passion is giving out dog tags in hopes of preventing more drownings.
First, a drowning in Burnsville, then an apparent drowning in Loring Park. Just a few of the recent headlines that hit this mother especially hard.
It's heartbreaking. It's heartbreaking to see that, you know, as we've just entered into the summer season.
Katie Taylor lost her own daughter in a Minneapolis pool in 2007. Her lively and expressive six-year-old girl was pulled into a faulty drain. After 16 surgeries, she passed away.
You don't expect anything like that ever to happen. And I don't want someone else to have that same story. Abby was a swimmer, and we are an aquatic family. I think what's an important message for me is that your life can change in an instant.
After passing a law to make pools safer, she's working to get out lessons about water safety, pushing for anyone with a pool or a pond, no matter how small, to have a gate or cover. She also says to get kids into swimming lessons. Her organization, made in her daughter's name, also pushes pool owners to get their drains checked out yearly. They've gotten creative on their latest push, handing out these watchdog tags so adults can trade off watching kids.
You put it in your pool bag, you put it in your beach bag, whatever, and it's a reminder so that when you're around the water with your loved ones, that you take the time and say, okay, I'm the watcher right now.
Her hope is that adults hand off watch every 20 minutes. Her dream is that lives will be saved because her beloved daughter's was lost.
Abby's Hope also offers advice on making sure your pool drains are safely operating. They also have resources for finding affordable swim lessons.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Pastores, but we don't have a good prognosis for you. I don't wish that on anyone.
Still ahead, the story of a Minnesota man still feeling the effects of a COVID diagnosis almost 8 months ago. But first, a major warm-up on the way. Summer joins us with your forecast in 2 minutes.